μου ξανάρχονται ένα-ένα. Χρόνια δοξασμένα. Να ήτανε το 21. Να'ρθει μια στιγμή. Να περνάω καβαλάρης. Στο πλατή ταλώνει. Και με τον κολοκοτρόν να πίνα κρασί. Να πολεμάω τις μέρες στα κάστρα και το σπαθί μου να πιάνει φωτιά και να κρατάω τις νύχτες μετάστερα μια ομορφούλα αγκαλιά. Μου ξανάρχονται ένα-ένα χρόνια δοξασμένα. Να'τανε το 21. Να'ρθει μια βραδιά. Πρώτο στο χορό να σέρνω στη μοριά τις στράτες και έξω πίσω μου μανιάτες και οι ψαριανοί. Και όταν λαβωμένος γέρνω κάτω από τους μπαξέδες να μεραίνουν με νεξέδες, χέρια κι ουρανί. Να πολεμάω τις μέρες στα κάστρα και το σπαθί μου να πιάνει φωτιά και να κρατάω τις νύχτες μετάστρα μια ομορφούλα αγκαλιά. Ξανάρχονται ένα-ένα χρόνια δοξασμένα. Να'τανε το 21. Να'ρθει μια βραδιά.
Good evening, Chicago. Good evening, America. Good evening to the world watching this evening as Greektown, Chicago and the Pappas Post celebrate the 200th anniversary of Greek Independence Day. March 25th, what a day. What a day in all of our lives. Every year we come together to celebrate our pride for our Greek heritage, our nostalgia for the past, and this year our hope for the future. What we're doing this year is very special. We have gathered a collection of native Chicagoans who are going to share their stories with us online. We have hundreds and hundreds of photographs that were collected by the community from parades past right here on Halsted Street, but also from the 50s and the 60s and the 70s and parades that took place in other parts of the city. We're so excited that you're all with us this evening. We have a special collection of beautiful content that we're excited to share with you.
Zito 25 Martio. There's nothing like being in Chicago and experiencing a parade, in particular, a Greek parade. And if you're of Greek origin, watching the children of Greek heritage march down Halsted Street in costume, and watching the various organizations extend their ethnic pride to Americans is something of a spectacle. Watching the Evzones from Greece march down Halsted Street and entertaining them in the evening, you know, they're really quite handsome and good looking. That was lots of fun, feeding them pizza and taking them over to Pizios' studio to watch movies. They got a big kick out of that. But, you know, this is an ethnic town, and I've never hidden the fact that I'm ethnic. In fact, I've never hidden from anyone that I am Greek. I am so proud to be Greek. I'm so proud to say how many young Greeks that I have behind the scenes assisted. And as I look toward our future, I know that there is a great stream of youngsters behind me, learning the traditions, appreciating everything about the culture, the language, the philosophy, and the religion. And I look to our community with great pride and great relief that we remember who we are. Zito 25 Martiu.
Hi, it's Dean Richards from the Morning News on WGN-TV and WGN Radio. I know that Richards doesn't sound very Greekish. My mom was Greek, and we were raised with the Greek culture and, of course, all that great food, too. I'm happy to be participating in this virtual Greek Independence Day celebration with some memories of Chicago's Greektown neighborhood. When I was about 6 or 7 years old, my yaya and I would get on the bus on the south side and head all the way up to Halsted Street so she could have lunch with her Greek lady friends. Now, back then, one of the most popular places in town was Diana's Grocery and Restaurant, an old school Greek grocery store in front with a few tables for service in the back where they would munch on meze and sweets and, of course, talk in Greek, of course, for hours and hours while I waited. A Greektown is where every special family occasion took place. When my mom wanted a day off from cooking, when I was able to drive on my own, my friends and I would pile into my old 68 Tempest and we'd head to Greektown and wait in line for hours to eat at one of the restaurants there. They'd serve us shots of ouzo while we were waiting. We never told them that we weren't even close to the legal drinking age. Don't do that now, kids. It was a place of heritage and tradition and joy. Happy Greek Independence Day, Chicago.
Tekeraki munia pro feke muna pepato na pienos koskolio na mastenos ramata tu theu ramata. I love you, Greece.
So growing up, the Greek parade was always a fixture of my youth. I went to Plato School and Assumption Church, which is also known as Panagia, and we always had a float. So I called my mother because I had this memory that even though I always thought the parade was in March, I remember on my birthday, which is May 15th, being on the parade route and seeing the Thesproti and him giving me a blessing. And that was a very powerful memory. I think I was 8 or 9 years old. And she said, oh, it's because it was so cold. They moved the parade some years. And so I don't know if anyone else remembers that, but I also called my sister and I said, what do you remember about the Greek parade in our youth? And she said that she recalls 1 year everyone was on our float was wearing more like goddess togas than the traditional Greek costume that we typically would wear. And she said, of course, it was a freezing cold year, and she just remembers shivering through the float in this ridiculous outfit that was sleeveless and like a Greek goddess on a bunch of us grade schoolers. So I thought that was a fun memory.
The Greeks have been involved in these kinds of events for thousands of years and for a variety of reasons. Originally, parades and processions were part of religious rites and festivals, where the community would begin at one point in the city and end up at a temple where they would perform sacrifices and in the end have a giant barbecue together. And really, that's what processions and parades are all about. They're about being together in community, about eating and drinking, about letting loose and relaxing in a time where work was the everyday reality for most people. And most importantly, parades and processions were an opportunity for Greeks to gather together, to strengthen their sense of communal identity, and really grow together in a sense of what it means to be a family.
Αυτούς που έχησαν το όνομα τους για να είναι η πατρίδα μας ελεύθερη. Ζήτω η Ελλάδα.
What did you say?
Ζήτω η Ελλάδα.
Ζήτω η Ελλάδα.
Ζήτω η Ελλάδα.
Πώς περπατάνε οι Εύζωνες? Let me show me. Ωμ, τομ, τομ. Κοίτα εδώ, πω, πω. Good job. This way. Let me see. Μπράβο. Bravo!
The Greek Parade is an opportunity for all Hellenes to showcase our history as well as our vision for the future. I remember with fondness when I participated as president of the Pan-Arcadian Federation in 2012 through 2014. It was a wonderful collection of all our fraternal organizations under the Pan-Arcadian Federation umbrella to showcase to the Greek community in Chicago all the various peoples of Arcadia.
Today, we celebrate March 25th. There are parades that should be happening maybe next year. We're gonna be together in those streets waving our flag. But for now, I want you to remember who you are, where you came from, and whether you're Greek or Greek American or a Philhellene, we celebrate what Greeks have given to the world, and that's so many things. So we wish you a fantastic March 25th. Zito elas, and zito ikuspende martiu. Mwah, mwah, mwah.
So before COVID, there were two times a year that just filled my heart, filled my spirit as a Greek American. The one was Anastasi, when thousands of people would sing Christos Anesi together. But something that surpassed even that, every year at the parade, that quiet moment right before thousands of Greek Americans, young and old alike, from the smallest children to the oldest grandparents, sang the national anthem, the Ethniko Hymno. And they hear our whole community come together right at that moment. That was just a holy moment, something that made the blood inside of you feel blue and white, and something that I can't wait to experience again in the post-COVID world.
Του Μιχαλάκη όλη νύχτα λέει. κλαίγαμε τραγούδι για τη λευτεριά κι όλη νύχτα κλαίγαμε Γοργόνα Παναγιά. Όλη νύχτα λέγαμε τραγούδι για τη λευτεριά κι όλη νύχτα κλαίγαμε Γοργόνα Παναγιά.
Greeks in Chicago have been marching for over 125 years. In fact, we do know from the Chicago Tribune archives that the first Greek Independence Day parade actually took place all the way back in 1895. It's hard to believe we've been doing this for so long. It is, in fact, the oldest known Greek Independence Day parade in this hemisphere. We've got some special photographs from the archives of the Pappas Post that we are sharing for the very first time.
Famous saying is, better an hour of freedom than 40 years of prison and slavery. Caliste era de horas, eleftheris zoi, para saranda chronia, escrava que fila aqui, para saranda chronia, escrava que fila aqui. Zito ilas.
Happy birthday, Greece! Στα πολύπαλια τα χρόνια, όχι στο σπριν γεννηθεί, η Παναγιά στην εκκλησία πίνα προσευχητή.
Έχει για καημένα κόσμα, έχει για δικά ζωή και σύνδυση η πατρίδα έχει για παντοτινή. Σύστε διαδέσει το ψάρι, ούταν το συναμωδία και οι σουρωτήσας δεν ζουνε δίχως την ελευθερία, ελευθερία ή θάνατος.
Στρατηγέ κολοκοτρώνει, γέρο του Μωριά, το σπαθί σου λευτερώνει, καστρά και χωριά. Της παλικαριάς στο κάστρο είσαι το τρανό και της ελευθεριάς στο άστρο το πιο φωτεινό. Ζήτω ελευθερία 21.
Myself, my sister Urania Prokos, my brother George Champis, honestly, we don't even remember a year where we did not participate, all of us, οικογενειακός, in the Greek parades, legendary Greek parades here in Chicago. My father was a Greek school teacher for many, many years here in Chicago, at St. George, at St. Basil's, and every year we marched, every single year. Some of the best memories I've ever had, specifically down Michigan Avenue. One particular year, I was very lucky and was selected to be the Simeon Fora. I was carrying the Greek flag in all of my blue and white, probably back in the 80s. My big hair, my white and blue outfit, and I could not have been more proud to see all the crowds on Michigan Avenue every year celebrating our culture, our heritage. Zito I Kosti Pemti Martiu, Zito I Elada, ke Zito I Obogenia tu Chicago.
The Greek parade has been a big part of our family's life for generations. I went as a child some 40 years ago with my Greek school. My parents were immigrants from Peloponneso, and to be honest, I didn't go to the parade for a number of years until I had my own daughter. My wife and I enrolled our daughter in a Greek school, and she went to the parade in her Amalia. So that sort of completed the circle for us, and we continue to attend the Greek parade with our daughter. It's a wonderful family event, and it's also an opportunity for all of the Greek organizations and Greek schools to show their strength in numbers, to show everyone else in the community from the whole Chicago area what they do and how many kids they have in their schools, and also how well disciplined they are. You know, you're gonna see some schools where the kids kind of drift here and there on the street as they march. We were drilled for weeks and months, even on the sidewalks and the parking lots in the suburbs before we would take the bus downtown and walk with almost military precision and pride in our fustaneles or our other uniforms. Happy Greek Independence Day, Chicago. Chronia pola, zito I Ellada.
I have participated in the parade since I was a preschooler. I started out with the St. Demetrios Greek Orthodox Church preschool, and then I continued when I was part of the Protipo Piraiko Greek school as well. I then founded the first ever Greek club at Whitney Young Magnet High School, so I made sure that we were on the roster every year for that as well. And then afterwards, I participated with the Hellenic Student Association at Loyola University Chicago. But I do think that the culmination of all of my experiences was when I was hired by the Chicago Tribune to film the Greek parade. And as the honorary Greek on staff, I felt that it was my duty to historically document this event that I had participated in for so many years. It really felt like I had years of just pre-production experience and this internal compass of a storyboard, knowing exactly what details to cover and which moments to look out for, the detailing of the costumes, kids' faces as they light up, waving Greek flags, and just really capturing the true emotions that a lot of Greek Americans feel during this time. And I feel that the parade is not just a celebration of independence, but an expression of cultural identity as Greek Americans. And it's always really great to grow up in a city that makes you feel welcomed and showcases the diversity that the city has to offer.
March 25th is the Feast of the Annunciation in the Greek Orthodox Church. It is the announcement of the Virgin Mary that she is going to give birth to Christ, the Savior of our souls. It is the day of freedom for the human race. It's also a second feast day, the feast day of the freedom of the Greek nation. For it was on that same day that the architects of the Greek Revolution rose up against tyranny and slavery. They were occupied for over 400 years by the Ottomans. On the 25th of March, the day of the Annunciation of our freedom, was the same day that they announced the freedom over tyranny. So March 25th is a significant day in the feast day and in the mindset of Orthodox Christians everywhere throughout the world, but most especially among the Greek nation. The parades and festivities that surround this day are magnificent. From the time I was a child, maybe 8 or 9 years old, I remember marching on Michigan Avenue in the streets of Chicago, wearing the traditional fustanella and marching to the beat of Greek Revolution and announcing to the world, really, what this day was all about. Years and years and years later, as I grew up and I became a priest and then a bishop of the church, I remember turning to my metropolitan, my bishop of blessed memory, and saying, "Your Eminence, I remember marching in these parades from the time I was a child, and I'm still marching in them, but they have a different meaning now. It's a meaning of witness. It's a meaning of announcing freedom. It's a meaning of overcoming tyranny." At a time when I was a child wearing a fustanella, taking the CTA, or the rapid system in Chicago, the public transportation system really, with my grandmother holding my hand, you could only imagine the looks we were getting of a young boy wearing what amounts to a skirt, and not knowing really what it meant. But once there, surrounded by my fellow students and others proclaiming to the world freedom over tyranny, freedom over slavery, and understanding what this day meant, I was able to proudly say, "Zito I kosipemti martiu, zito I eleftheria."
The March 25th celebrations have been something that I've always treasured in my life. It was about celebrating the freedom fighters of 1821. It's about giving back and recognizing the generations past and everything that they have accomplished. It's about serving an obligation to our youth and teaching them some of our traditions and our cultures. And more importantly, it was a sense of unity that we had here in our community, where we all came together to celebrate our accomplishments and still strive to do more. As a young girl, I remember dressing up in my Amalia outfit and marching with my friends from Greek school. And those friendships have been something that I still have till today, some of them turning into Gubario. It was about marching with the village groups that my parents came from Agia Lavra from Calavrita, and Ayos Andreas from Patra, and marching with my mom and dad's relatives and their friends and family. I think one of the most memorable moments was in 2016, when it was the first time in decades that we had the Evzones that came back to march with us here in Chicago. We have a flag-raising ceremony that happens at the Daly Center, which is the main courthouse here in the Chicagoland area. Around 240 courtrooms in the building. We hadn't planned for the fact that the Evzones could not sit on a bus with their uniforms. And so they had to change someplace. And they called upon me and they asked if we could possibly change my courtroom into a staging room for the Evzones. It was one of the proudest moments that I could ever remember. The entire court building was amazed as they were walking through the halls of the Halls of Justice here in the Chicagoland area. They walked up and we proudly raised the Greek flag at Daly Plaza and we sang the Greek national anthem. There is nothing more chilling, and although I'm a very proud American, I have Greek blood. And when I see that flag raised and I hear the Ethniko Hymno and I watch the Evzones, it's something that I will never forget. Zito to ikosiena, zito yelas.
My fondest memories of the parade of the city of Chicago are when I was a young kid going down Michigan Avenue. Obviously, the Evzones coming from Greece was one of the biggest highlights. And then being able to see our Greek community as a spotlight across this great city was obviously one of the most special things. Something that's without question translated into our kids, into who we are as a Greek family. I was fortunate because both my parents were ingrained in the city of Chicago as radio hosts for over 55 years. Being able to see that day was the beginning of the spring, and looking to the summer to be able to go to Greece each and every summer. And so the parade in the city of Chicago was one that celebrated blue and white, everything that was so special about being Greek, our heritage, and watching the city of Chicago and Michigan Avenue lined up with the flags that we continue to have and is a part of our family. And to this day, our kids marching down Greektown, we make sure that we mark that day and that we're there. So happy anniversary. Chronia pola. We will be celebrating all year. 2021 is a special time and we're fortunate to be a part of it. Thank you.
Our kids look so forward to the parade. They march proudly, wearing a fustanella and a costume, proudly wearing their Plato emblems. But what makes me most proud is that our children at Plato, who are of other ethnicities, march just as proudly along their Greek peers as Philhellenes. They're very proud to be affiliated with our culture. They're very proud to be honored in the parade as we march together. They're very proud to speak Greek in the poems that we perform at our March 25th celebration. These little Hellenes that we're educating at Plato, along with our Greek children, I believe are gonna grow up and truly change the world. I'm very proud of them.
A really quick story with you. It is by far my favorite memory from the Greek Independence Day parades over the years. It is when I first came back home to Chicago to be a reporter in my hometown, which was my dream. And so I'm working for NBC5, and I remember they were asking all the reporters and the anchors and the talent and everything, hey, would you be in the Polish parade or the Columbus parade? Would you be in the Irish parade or the Bud Billiken parade or the Pride parade? And of course I said, yes, 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 I'll be on all these parades. And then March comes around and I'm like, wait a minute, where's the ask for the Greek Independence Day parade? There was no float in the Greek Independence Day parade from any TV station in town. And I remember saying, we gotta fix this. So I went to my station bosses and management and the community affairs folks, and I just said, hey, could we have a float this year? Do you think we could make that happen? And sure enough, like, they pulled it together in like a couple of weeks. They had the Greek flags out and the blue and white, and boom, we had a float there. And I just remember riding that float in my hometown, and I was just so happy. I was just proud to be Greek. And it's a great time to look back at our heritage and remember what's important, celebrating 200 years of Greek independence. Zito Ellada, long live Greece. And I just can't wait to go back and travel there again. I hope everyone's well. See everyone soon when we get back to socializing again.
We've now come to a special part of the evening where we're going to give you a chance to take part and sing along. We have selected a beautiful song called Nata Netoi Kosiena, which later in our broadcast, you will see the voice of Greece, Glikeria, performing this, especially for this event. But before we do that, we're going to give you a chance to do a karaoke version. We have the song with an instrumental version of it. It's a beautiful song by Sotia Tsotu, who wrote the lyrics, and Stavros Kouyoumzis, who wrote the music. We got the music for you. We've got the lyrics on screen. Enjoy, take a break, sing along. We'll see you soon. We've now come to the part of the evening that everyone has been waiting for with enthusiasm. You know, with the magic of the internet and the magic of Zoom, we were literally able to get into the studio in Athens, Greece, where Glikeria and her entire team of musicians recorded this version of Natane Toikosiena, especially for this program this evening. She has a very special bond in her heart for the people of Chicago. She has many fond memories of performing here in Chicago, and she's very excited about coming back here one day. But in the meantime, enjoy Glikeria.
Φίλοι και φίλες στο Σικάγο και παντού όπου μας βλέπετε. Φέτος δεν μπορούμε να γιορτάσουμε όπως τα θέλαμε. Δεν μπορούμε να παρελάσουμε όπως κάθε χρόνο. Ας ενωθούμε με ένα αγαπημένο τραγούδι που το ξέρετε όλοι. Χρόνια πολλά, Ελλάδα!
Δοξασμένα να ήταν το 21 να έρθει μια στιγμή να περνάω καβαλάρης στο πλατή ταλόνι και με τον κολοκοτρώνι να πει να κράσει να πολεμάω τις μέρες στα κάστρα και το σπαθί μου να πιάνει φωτιά και να κρατάω τις νύχτες με τ' άστρα μια ομορφούλα αγκαλιά. Μου ξανάρχονται ένα-ένα χρόνια δοξασμένα να ήταν το 21 να'ρθει μια βραδιά. Μωριά τις στράτες κι έξω πίσω μου μανιάτες και οι ψαριανοί κι όταν λαβόμενος γέρνω κάτω απ' τους μπαξέδες να με ρένουμε με ξέδες χέρια κι ουρανοί να πολεμάω τις μέρες στα κάστρα και το σπαθί μου να πιάνει φωτιά και να κρατάω τις νύχτες με τ' άστρα μια ομορφούλα αγκαλιά. Μου ξανάρχονται ένα-ένα χρόνια δοξασμένα να ήταν το 21 να'ρθει μια βραδιά.